Hey everybody, I'm just going to jump right into the book work, whereas if you work the book will work you. And I just want to ask some questions. Do you like salespeople? You know, I'm not going to say I either like salespeople or don't like salespeople, but I study salespeople and I found out that there are certain things about salespeople that rub people the wrong way. You know, the Bible talks about buying and selling, in particular in Matthew. And you might see in Matthew, the 10th chapter and the 16th verse, Jesus actually says this, "Behold, I send you out as sheep in the midst of wolves. Therefore, be wise as serpents and as harmless as doves." And then if you go over to Matthew, the 21st chapter, verse 12 and 13, you'll see these words. Jesus entered the temple courts and drove out all who were buying and selling there. He overturned the tables of the money changers and the benches of those selling doves. "It is written," he said, "my house will be called a house of prayer, but you are making it a den of robbers." You know, I thought it was interesting that Jesus in the temple and he got so upset, some said mad, some said angry, at the what happens when people buy and sell. And you know, if you know anything about buying and selling, usually one person is trying to get something a lot less than what it's worth, and the other person is trying to sell something for a lot more than what it's worth. But it just made me think about some of the things that we go through as Christians. You know, I think people really try to take advantage of us as Christians when it comes to selling us stuff. You know, there are many people, especially those of us in the church, we try to be as honest as possible in our business dealings. But people will try to change your character because either they think you don't know anything or they think they can take advantage of you. And it's just so much that goes on. But as a Christian, how do you respond to salespeople? You know, I'm so amazed. I have people come back all the time to my house trying to sell stuff. But really, they're not trying to sell stuff as much as there are things that I need, like when the AC go out, the heater goes out, the roof leaks, need new windows, need new carpeting, need your house painted, need maintenance and things like that. People will come out and sell you a whole lot of nothing. And what's so funny, you know, now, bear in mind, let me back up a little bit. I do have some sales history, and not all salespeople are bad. There are some great salespeople. But you know, it's amazing how what messes a lot of salespeople up, especially from those of us who are Christian and those of us who have an idea about economy, is you try to sell us too much stuff that we don't need. You try to sell us the top of the line this and the top of the line that, when the only thing we really need is to keep our house cool. The only thing we need is to keep our house warm. The only thing we need is we don't want our roof leaking. We don't need the top of the line everything, especially if that ain't what we had in our house or on our car or whatever it is you're trying to sell us. You know, I remember one time when I learned this trick. Whenever you go into a store and you want somebody to help you, walk toward the most expensive merchandise in the store. You know, when I go into an auto parts store, I usually like to try to walk over toward the tires. Because when I walk toward the tires, I know a salesperson will come over there and try to sell some tires, because usually the tires are one of the most expensive items that they're selling in the store. And I might only want some oil, but I'll go over to the tire just to get people to come over there, because I know salespeople are like sharks. When they see blood in the water, they will come out. But what does that have to do with book work? Jesus told us that we are to be wise as serpents and harmless as doves. You don't have to get mad at a salesperson. You don't have to get angry at them. You don't have to start fussing and going back and forth with them. You know how much you're willing to spend on whatever it is you're buying. But what gets me is this. A salesperson will come in, and trust me, I understand some of the sales schemes. They have to try to connect with you. They see something. Oh, I see you're a Falcon fan. Then they want to talk about football. Oh, I see your kids in school. They want to talk about stuff like that. And I understand connecting as someone trying to sell. But a good salesperson should try to find out what it is that that person needs. And once you find out what that person needs, that's what you try to offer them. Don't try to offer nothing to make you a big commission. I know commissions are good and you want a lot of money because you're working hard for it. But would you rather have a big commission or would you rather have a sale and probably future sales by selling the right price product? So for those of us who have issues with people who like to sell, you know, and it's so funny to me because as a pastor, people just think I guess clueless when it comes to business dealing, because they'll try to offer me, and every now and then you might get me, but you ain't gonna get me twice for the same thing. But you know, as people in the body of Christ, we still have to be nice to salespeople. We still have to listen to them, but it's okay to call them on their BS when they give you some BS. You know, you don't have to use BS, but you can call them to the carpet and let them know, hey, wait a minute. You're not selling me that. I'm not buying that. What does that consist of? What all comes with that? And once you find out the difference between what's the labor cost, what's the cost of the parts, and all the other things, then you can make a conscientious decision. But what got Jesus mad was they were selling in the temple. And the temple, you know, and I know there are a lot of churches who have bake sales and goods and sales and things like that. And if you sell more than you pray, if you have more fundraisers than you pray, if you're always doing stuff to try to get money, if you're always buying and selling and you're doing more of that than prayer, you are the type of person that Jesus was angry with, especially if you're doing it in the house of the church. And I know churches have need. They do car washes at churches. They sell tickets at churches. They have bake sales at churches and all these things. And I understand the need of it. Praise God, from whom all blessings flow. Thank you so much for tuning in to the Champions for Christ Christian Church Bookwork. And I'm your host, Dr. Darryl L. Jones, the senior pastor of Champions for Christ Christian Church, where I praise God and thank God often for allowing me the opportunity to serve some of the greatest people you would ever want to meet. You can follow us every Sunday morning on Facebook Live. Just go to my page, Dr. Darryl L. Jones, at 10 o'clock every Sunday morning on Facebook Live. You can also follow us on our Zoom video conference. You can go to our website, www.c4cchurch.com, and see all the latest information that's happening with Champions for Christ Church. And if you have any questions or if you'd like to know more, you can email us at c4cchurch@gmail.com. Thank you for watching The Book Work, because if you work the book will work for you. Until we're together again, we are Champions for Christ. Peace.